Hello, welcome back guys. Welcome back to a brand new video of Mighty Ghost Hack YouTube channel. So guys, after a long time, I am uploading a video on Python script. It might be around after 6 months. In between, I was not active and not even uploading video consistently. And rather than the Python script, I uploaded on other topic as well. So guys, you can check the channel playlist, you may find those video may be more useful based on your preference. So let's talk about today's video. In this video, we are looking for a Python script that will help us to retrieve useful information from YouTube videos link. Basically, we will look into a script that will parse the data from HTML and render it into the output screen. And here all those data are retrieved from only the YouTube videos, not other videos link will be useful. We simply parsing data from the YouTube links. Now here on screen you will see the GitHub repo where I uploaded a Python script. Currently it's private. Once the video which I recording right now are get public, then I will make this repository as public so that you guys can access, and also put the link into description so you guys can clone it and do some more experiment as whatever you want. Now jump into the Python script and let's see what are the different information will available to us when we execute this script. Now here on screen you will see the collection of data which will contain the video title, views, description, and mainly the tags, which is the more important, and it contains every tag that available in the videos. Then date publish and upload date, which may be different in some case. Later, category of ID, then channel ID, then video ID, and most important, the thumbnail link is also available. Let me show you the valid link by opening the thumbnail link in the browser. Alright, see, it's working, so it is valid as well. Here are other useful information also available. Channel link, subscriber count, like, dislike, and the video length is also provided. So this much data we can collect from a single Python script. Now let me explain to you Python script line by line. First let's go into bottom side. Here inside of main function I created an instance of class and pass the URL as an argument inside of class. Then later call the getVideoDetail function that will return the object, or you can say dictionary in Python language, which is later printed with the help of PrettyPrint module. Alright, now look into the script. Here firstly we need to import 4 packages. First one is for the downloading HTML code from the requested URL. That's why we need a request module. Then beautiful soup for the extracting data from the HTML string, and it is a very popular for the web scraping, so we will use this. And later RE module, which means the regular expression module, and it require for the pattern matching. This one is by default available in Python. And after that PrettyPrint module to show the output on terminal with well structured format. So these 4 modules are mainly used in this script, and we only need to install the request and beautiful soup module because the rest of them are already available when you install the Python on your machine. So for the installation, here I provided a command. Simply copy this command and paste it into the terminal. Here in my case is already installed, so it won't install again. Also, I wanted to show you the Python version. So here I am using the Python 3.9 version, which is the latest version if I am not wrong. So once the installation is done, then we will import the module. Now let's take a look at Video Scrapper class. Here I just put a random name. You can give any whatever you want. In this class, there is a one init method. And this parameter which we get as a URL is going to pass into another self variable URL. So that makes a URL will be available to the whole class methods. Now let's look into the get video detail function, which does not take any argument, but we need to pass the self which is required as per the rule, and this function will return us the dictionary. So here return type is mentioned as dictionary. Now inside of this method, first we will call the get request with the help of the request module, which will be imported on the top. And once you get the response, then we will use the text method, which is belong to the request module. Here you can use the content method as well, but both are the different. One will provide us the Unicode data and another will provide the byte formatted data. And now we require HTML and XML formatted data. That's why I prefer the text method instead of the content. And you can see here the response.text method is used, and which is a pass under the beautiful soup module. Now the beautiful soup method contains the main two arguments. One is markup text, and markup text is basically a string of web page, and another is parser. Here we use the HTML parser because the text which we are going to pass are HTML, and it is the defaultly available parser in beautiful soup. So once this beautiful soup method get called, then its output gets stored into the soup variable. Let me first show you the data. For that, let me comment out the below lines. Alright, now here I added the some file writing code. This I added because to show you the data which will get after the request. Now let me run. Now after running the script, we are getting none. This is because of the return type of this get videos detail function are commented. Lastly, we are trying to catch into the data variable, which is printed here. That's why we are getting none. So let's open the file. Alright guys, see, this is the data, and we will do the all the parsing from this data to get some useful information. Now let's go back and let me undo the changes. So far we see the data. In the next line, I declare the single object type variable, which will going to store the data, and lastly going to return us. Now finally we come to the parsing part. For parsing, let me comment out the below line again, and it's better to explain you line by line. So now let me uncomment this line as well. Here I wanted to show you the metadata. So let me run this. Alright guys, now simply look at here. Most of the data which we require, such as title, description, and mainly the tag also, and the URL of video is also available to us, and other data is also available you can collect from this here. And lastly, here you will find the published date, upload date, and video category. So most of the data are collected from this meta section. Now let me comment out this again and uncomment the below line. So right now you can see these lines, the title, description and other data are passing from the meta section. Let me run the script and show you the output again. Here all these data are collected from the meta tags. Alright, so far we got the data from the meta section. Now we will look into the thumbnail URL, which is available to us inside of another tag, inside of another span tag. Let me show you that as well in data field. Here I paused the video and started again because it take me some time to find this line. Now here you can see the thumbnail URL is on the inside of span tag. Okay, now let's go back. And guys, you don't need to do parsing for the thumbnail URL. All you can do is simply pass the video ID in between the thumbnail URL. Right now I haven't mentioned in this script, but once the video is available to you, I will add those lines as well. So simply you can clone it from GitHub. Now simply run the script and check it's working. Okay, thumbnail URLs is also working fine. Next, channel URL. It simply created by the channel ID, simply passing into the URL. Here initial URL is always the same, and lastly we pass the channel ID which we got from the meta section. Now next we have to retrieve the data from JS object. This is the some part which is more critical. If you know the data which is not changing continuously and not change until the page refresh are available to us HTML, such as title which is not changing, description which is not changing in real time. I am talking about real time, but some data such as like, dislike and subscriber count are updating dynamically, and all those data are updated dynamically with the help of JS function. And here I didn't find any class that contained the all such information as well as the video length as well. So I used the some another way which used to find all those data. So we can't parse by simply using the beautiful soup module. For that I use some logical expressions. Let's see the subscriber count in the file. Let me search by channel subscriber count, and here you can find it. And these data are not coming under any tag. Similarly, let me show you the for the like and dislike as well. Now let's go back. Let me uncomment this line, and this single line will collect only those data which is a match with the specified string, which is matched with specified string, then stored into the sub details variable. And the below line is just an example of finding an index, and after that doing some slicing based on that index. Let me explain by typing. Here we do some slicing by specifying the starting and ending index. If you know the Python language very well, then you may understand it very easily. And those starting and ending index found with the help of the find keyword. Here in this data, you can see the starting text is a subscriber count text and ending text is a subscribers. And once the slicing is done, we do the splitting, and splitting is done by the double quote. After that, all those process you will get the sub count is in the array. So in order to access the sub count, we specify the minus 1 value in the bracket, because it is the subscriber count which we get are in the last index. And later I am doing strip to remove all the extra spaces. So after all this, you will get the subscriber count. Now similarly for like, dislike, we use the same way. Here icon type like is used to find the similar text. Here I am finding similar text because it is not good to use the find keyword from all our data which is available to us. Similar way, we will find the length of video as well. And one more important thing is video length is available to us in second. So we need to convert it in WELP format as we seeing the display in the video. In order to convert into hours, minute and second format, here I added a simple function that will take a second as an argument, and here return type will be the string, and this function will do some calculation and return us the WELP formatted video length. Now in this line you can see the regular expression is used. Here regular expression will return us the number from the string, and lastly convert it into the integer with the help of int keyword and pass into the function. So the function will get second as an argument. So lastly you will get the video length. So this is it guys. You can make any changes in logical expression as well if you find any other easy way. So this is it for this video. Hope you enjoy it. If you found it useful, then surely like, and your single like will motivate me to upload more videos. And also comment on this video if you have any doubt. And lastly, don't forget to share with your friends. Till then, bye. We'll be right back.